Hello, aviation enthusiasts, and welcome back to Histories of Airliners. The fate of Lockheed's airliner prototypes are as varied as the aircraft themselves. Some, like the Lockheed Vega, were lost, never to be seen again. Others, such as the L-188 Electra prototype, were converted into the standard production models. The L-1011 TriStar prototype, though groundbreaking, ultimately met a less fortunate end, with some prototypes being scrapped and others being preserved as static displays. While the exact details vary for each model, these prototypes played a crucial role in the development and evolution of Lockheed's airliners, leaving their mark on aviation history. The Lockheed Vega prototype, christened the Golden Eagle, marked a significant step forward in aviation history. Designed by the visionary duo of Jack Northrop and Gerard Vulti, who would both go on to found aviation companies of their own, the Vega showcased innovative features like a streamlined monocoque fuselage and cantilever wings. Its maiden flight in 1927 demonstrated remarkable speed and range, capturing the attention of aviators and the public alike. While the Golden Eagle was lost in the dull air race, its legacy lived through its production variants. The Vega was a symbol of aviation progress, powering record-breaking flights and inspiring future generations of aircraft designers. The Lockheed Model 10 Electra prototype, registered as November X-ray 233 Yankee, is a testament to aviation history. First taking flight in 1934, this sleek all-metal airliner revolutionized commercial aviation with its twin-tail design, a feature suggested by future Lockheed aircraft design great Clarence Kelly Johnson. After initial testing, this aircraft joined the fleet of Northwest Airlines, serving on routes across the United States. Throughout its operational life, the plane underwent modifications and upgrades, demonstrating its ability and longevity. Eventually, this aircraft would fly for the Royal Canadian Air Force, where it would unfortunately burn out in a fire on the ground in Ontario in 1941. This plane's legacy extends beyond its service in commercial aviation, as it played a pivotal role in the development of subsequent Lockheed models and contributed to the advancement of aviation technology as a whole. The Lockheed Model 12 Electra Jr. prototype, registered as November X-ray 16052, emerged as a smaller, more affordable variant of the iconic Model 10 Electra. First taking flight in 1936, this elegant aircraft boasted a streamlined design and advanced features for its time. This aircraft served as a testbed for the Model 12, undergoing rigorous flight testing to refine its performance and handling characteristics. After its successful evaluation, the Model 12 gained popularity among private owners and corporate operators, renowned for its speed, comfort, and reliability. This aircraft's contributions to the development and success of the Model 12 solidified its place in aviation history. After serving in Mexico and India, the aircraft would eventually be broken up in Delhi in 1943. The Model 14 Super Electra prototype, registered as November X-ray 17382, represented a significant advancement in the Electra lineage. First taking flight in 1937, this larger and more powerful variant of the Model 10 offered increased range and payload capacity. This aircraft played a crucial role in the development of the Model 14 aircraft that would follow, undergoing post-construction testing of its performance and systems. Following its testing period, the Model 14 would go on to fly for Northwest Airlines before moving on to Nicaragua, where it would eventually be lost after a crash during takeoff in 1946. The Model 14 gained popularity among airlines worldwide, known for its reliability, efficiency, and luxurious passenger accommodations. The Model 14 would be prized for its reliability, being flown on record-breaking flights that would include a circumnavigation of the globe by Howard Hughes. This aircraft's contributions to the success of the Model 14 line solidified its place in aviation history. The Lockheed Model 18 Lodestar prototype, registered as November X-ray 17385, is a converted Model 14 Super Electra. It marked a departure from the Electra series, transitioning it into a more utilitarian and versatile aircraft. First taking flight in 1939, the Lodestar offered a spacious cabin, impressive range, and robust performance, making it suitable for various roles, including passenger transport, cargo hauling, and military operations. This aircraft played a pivotal role in the development of the Model 18. The prototype aircraft would eventually see service with many different owners over the years, before ending up in Argentina with an airline known as Líneas Aéreas de Cuyo. The aircraft would be broken up soon afterwards. The Lodestar's success led to widespread adoption by airlines, military forces, and private owners worldwide, solidifying its legacy as a reliable and adaptable aircraft. The Lockheed Constellation prototype, registered as November X-ray 25600, marked a pivotal moment in aviation history. First taking flight in 1943, this iconic airliner revolutionized long-distance travel with its sleek design, powerful engines, and pressurized cabin. This aircraft underwent rigorous testing, paving the way for the production of the initial L-049 Constellation. However, due to World War II, this aircraft would be modified into the United States Army Air Force C-69 cargo aircraft. During the prototype's lifetime, it also served as the test aircraft for Lockheed and Howard Hughes. This aircraft would eventually be converted into the L-1049 Super Constellation prototype and would perform aerodynamic testing for the United States Navy C-121-based AWACS aircraft before being broken up in 1958. This plane's legacy extends beyond its role as a prototype, as it continues to inspire aviation enthusiasts and serve as a reminder of Lockheed's innovative spirit. The Lockheed L-1649 Starliner prototype, registered as November 1649er, marked the pinnacle of propeller-driven airline technology. First taking flight in 1956, this elegant aircraft boasted a sleek design, powerful engines, and a luxurious cabin. After initial testing was complete, paving the way for production of the L-1649A Starliner, this airliner would go on to the commercial market. This iconic airliner revolutionized long-distance travel, offering unparalleled speed, range, and comfort. This prototype aircraft would stay with Lockheed until 1971, when it was withdrawn from service at the Nagoya, Japan airport. From there, it was used as a restaurant in Chiba, Japan, until the aircraft was broken up in 1982. This aircraft's legacy extends beyond its role as a prototype, as it continues to captivate aviation enthusiasts and serve as a testament to Lockheed's engineering prowess. The Lockheed L-188 Electra prototype, registered as November 1881, marked a significant milestone in aviation history as the first large turboprop airliner produced in the United States. First taking flight in 1957, this groundbreaking aircraft showcased its impressive performance and innovative design. This aircraft underwent rigorous testing to refine its systems and ensure its reliability, paving the way for the production of the L-188A Electra. This iconic airliner revolutionized short-haul air travel, offering a balance of speed, efficiency, and comfort. The prototype aircraft was served with Pacific Southwest Airlines during the 1960s. After this, the aircraft would eventually end up with a company called Holiday Airlines Corporation in the early 1970s, with the aircraft then being broken up after 2009. The Electra design ultimately overcame early challenges and became a popular choice for airlines worldwide. The prototype's legacy as the pioneer for the L-188 Electra endures, forever etched in the annals of aviation history. The Lockheed Jetstar prototype, then registered as November 329er Juliet, marked a significant milestone in the history of corporate aviation. First taking flight in 1957, this sleek and powerful aircraft revolutionized executive travel with its speed, range, and luxurious cabin, becoming the model of which most future business aircraft would be based on. After the prototype's initial testing period paved way for the production of the Jetstar series, this iconic aircraft became a symbol of corporate success and prestige, serving a diverse clientele including government officials, business executives, and celebrities. The prototype would go on for many years as a test aircraft for Lockheed. This aircraft is now preserved at the Seattle Museum of Flight at Payne Field, Washington. This aircraft's legacy extends beyond its role as a prototype, as it continues to inspire aviation enthusiasts and serves as a testament to Lockheed's engineering prowess. The The Lockheed L-100 Hercules prototype, registered as November 1130 Echo, marked the transition of the iconic C-130 Hercules from a military workhorse to a versatile commercial airlifter. First taking flight in 1964, this groundbreaking aircraft showcased the adaptability of the Hercules platform for civilian operations. This prototype aircraft would not only be the prototype for the Dash 10 model, but after an extension was added, would be the first aircraft for the Dash 20 model series as well. From there, the aircraft would fly cargo for both Alaska Airlines and Delta Airlines before being returned to Lockheed and eventual exportation for service with the Philippine Air Force, where, according to records, is still flying to this day in 2024. This versatile aircraft type found widespread use in cargo transportation, humanitarian aid, and specialized missions, demonstrating its enduring legacy as a reliable and capable workhorse of the skies. The Lockheed L-1011 TriStar prototype, registered as November 1011, marked a significant milestone in the history of wide-body airliners. First taking flight in 1970, this innovative aircraft featured a trijet engine configuration along with advanced avionics, providing enhanced reliability and performance. This aircraft underwent rigorous testing to refine its systems and ensure its airworthiness, paving the way for the production of the L-1011 TriStar series. The prototype aircraft would be used for testing new systems until 1982, when it was partially broken up. From there, the cockpit and a large section of the passenger area would go on display in the 1980s Delta Airlines livery for use as a museum piece and a rentable conference room located at the Delta Flight Museum near the Atlanta International Airport. This iconic airliner revolutionized long-haul air travel, offering a balance of speed, efficiency, and comfort. Though its production run was relatively short, the L-1011 TriStar left an enduring legacy recognized for its technological advancements and distinctive design. The story of Lockheed's airliners is a testament to innovation, engineering excellence, and a relentless pursuit of pushing the boundaries of aviation. From the graceful Electra family to the mighty Constellation, the versatile Hercules to the luxurious Jetstar and the groundbreaking TriStar, Lockheed's aircraft has shaped the aviation industry. These iconic airliners have transported millions of passengers, carried vital cargo, and served as platforms for exploration and discovery. As we reflect on their legacy, let's remember to support channels like this one that strive to preserve aviation history and inspire future generations. By subscribing, liking, and sharing our videos, you help us continue to share these captivating stories and keep the spirit of aviation alive.